Sam. So yes, today I felt like making a video. This video will be short and I'll only be discussing one topic, but I felt it was very necessary to make this video and only talk about this topic. As we know, Harry's been traveling a lot. He was just in Italy, then he went to London, and then some people are saying now he's in Spain. I don't know, Harry Styles could be all over the map. I literally can't keep track of Harry Styles. But wherever Harry was recently, there were, of course, a group of fans who found out where he was, and they thought that they were entitled enough to either have a picture, an autograph, or for Harry to just have a conversation with them. Now, before I go into my opinion and your opinions, I'm gonna show you guys the TikTok that sparked this whole discussion. Now, as you guys could tell from the TikTok, he clearly had somewhere to be, but fans just couldn't accept that. So because Harry essentially ignored them, they decided to spray water at the car and say things like, oh, f*** you, and just act very annoyed and disappointed. I'm sure you guys already know my opinion about this, but I'm gonna say it anyway. I think this is disgusting. I do not condone this behavior as a One Direction fan. I do not associate with these other One Direction fans, and I hope you guys don't either. We don't claim them. I just think it's so stupid how some fans just feel so entitled to get a picture, an autograph, or to speak to Harry. Like, yes, I get it. You're excited. Your idol is right in front of you, but if you clearly see that Harry has somewhere to be, then just respect that. He doesn't owe you shit. And that's what some people have to understand about celebrities and their idols. Like, yes, we love them, but if you want to show your idols that you love them, you don't harass them by throwing things at them or saying you and making the celebrity feel bad. And this was actually quite a shock to me that people reacted in this way, because Harry Styles, as everyone knows, is a very nice person, and we all know that Harry usually stops and talks to fans, and he usually gives the fans the time of day. He's very good at that, unlike some other celebrities. Harry really, really appreciates his fans, and he's shown that countless times. Like, seriously, Harry can't cater to your needs and wants at all times. And yes, I understand this situation could have gone a lot worse. I have seen a lot more worse celebrity encounters. I understand it was just water and it wasn't like a riot, but that still doesn't excuse these fans' behavior. I just want everyone to know out there that this is not a good representation of all One Direction fans. And I think that's pretty indicative of every fandom. You have some bad apples in the fandom, but obviously not everyone is like that. So that is my opinion of this whole thing. Now I'm going to read some of your opinions about this specific situation. So this tweet says that TikTok about Harry's car getting splashed with water is literally so upsetting. Celebrities are normal people, and if he didn't want to stop to take pictures, then it's completely justified. It doesn't matter that they waited for him to come out. He does not owe anyone shit. Exactly, that's what I was saying before. Harry doesn't owe anyone anything. The man's got things to do. This person says, just what the f***? I have no words to express how childish this reaction is. Yeah, honestly, this is childish. I don't know how old these fans were, but honestly, it doesn't matter. No matter what age you are, you should not be treating another person like this. This person says, disgusting, toxic. They aren't Harry fans at all. They are toxic. Harry doesn't owe us anything. He's human like everyone else. Exactly. I hate when people hold celebrities to this higher standard as if they're not human. Like, yes, Harry has celebrity status, but Harry doesn't consider himself a celebrity. And to treat someone as if they're not a human being just because they're a celebrity is toxic. This person says, it's so rude, honestly. You wouldn't like it if they did it to you, then why do it to someone else, especially if you are a fan of them? Exactly. This isn't fan behavior. This is greedy entitlement. This person says, and people wonder why he didn't want to meet them. So I don't know what went on before this video. I don't know if the fans were acting really rowdy. This is the only clip I saw of this situation. And also, guys, sometimes it's not even Harry's choice to talk to the fans. Sometimes his bodyguards or his team of people around him say, hey, we have somewhere to go, and even if you want to talk to the fans, you can't. So how dare these people make it seem like it's all Harry's fault? I am like 99% sure that Harry's bodyguard specifically told him, no, we're not meeting up with fans today. We have to skip this one. And that is perfectly valid. This person says, and these are the reasons most celebrities don't like to interact with fans. That is so disrespectful. This person says this is straight up childish. Harry owes you nothing. If you are a fake fan like the people in this TikTok, then you don't deserve his kindness. Yeah, exactly. You can't treat a person like shit and expect kindness back. This says, dude, what the f-? It's not like a show he's expected to be at. OMG, gives me flashbacks to when people were f-ing jumping on top of his f-ing car. Yeah, this person makes a great point. If this was a Harry Styles meet and greet or signing, that would be the most appropriate and accepting environment to go up to Harry. And he would, of course, go up to you. But this was obviously a time where Harry had somewhere to be, it wasn't a meet and greet, and Harry is entitled to a personal life. This says they do realize he's human too, right? He has feelings just like everyone else. Gosh, sometimes people can just be so mean. Yeah, I don't know what's happened to humanity, honestly. This says, makes me sick. How can they do that? Clearly they aren't fans. Real fans would never do that. They are not fans. They are crazy. That's a shame. This says, those must not be longtime fans or real fans, because real Harrys protect him at all costs and don't throw tantrums like that if he has to go. How disrespectful and unkind. Yeah, honestly, I don't know how long these people have been fans of Harry Styles. I don't really even think that matters. Whether you've been a fan from 2010 or a fan yesterday, you just don't do this. And then this last comment is actually from one of my friends. She says, even fans of smaller musicians and bands sometimes expect them to come and say hi to their fans because they've been seen following the band for a long time or have spent a lot of money on their merch. I don't get it. Artists are literally just people, and if you're paying to see their shows or buy merch, that's all you should expect. Very well said, and that's why I ended on that one. I think most people can agree that a lot of this fan behavior happens a lot with pop artists or very commercialized artists. Like, I'm not sure if this type of fan behavior happens with like punk rock or alternative bands. I'm not quite sure, but I know that this happens a lot with boy bands and pop artists because, you know, they're more in the limelight in the media. Traditionally and stereotypically, they might have more younger fans. So yeah, I think the main thing to take away from this is that Harry's human, and we all have our moods, our good days, and our bad days. Like I said, maybe it wasn't even Harry's choice to not talk to the fans, but then again, maybe he wasn't in the best mood. Maybe he didn't feel that happy, and he didn't want to give off that energy to the fans, even though they were giving him bad energy. Like, honestly, there are many reasons why Harry didn't stop to talk to the fans, and you know what? Each one of those reasons are completely justifiable. Harry doesn't owe you an explanation for why he didn't come up to you, and you don't deserve his time. And that's all I'm gonna say. Again, if you guys have more opinions on this whole topic or anything related to this topic, write that down below. And like I said in my last video, I have a Discord up and running. If you want to have a safe and private place to chat about Larry Stylinson, One Direction, or any other topics outside of that, then join my Discord, link below. And like always, I make a new video whenever I want, so like and subscribe. All my social media is down in the description, and I will see you guys later. Bye. We'll be right back.